In this tutorial, we're going to take a look at how to make a half-hitched bottle wrap using paracord. I think that the biggest challenge in making this style of wrap is actually determining the cord length that you will need. You can either make a few rows of hitches, which I'm going to demonstrate, and then measure out the cord that you're going to need, or you can simply make do with a length of paracord, and when you run out, simply splice in more cord when you need it. Both ways work. I have started by attaching a cord using a cord lock, and I finished the ends using a couple of Celtic button knots. None of this is required, I just prefer this look. I am going to attach my working cord using a half hitch. And after that, we're going to start lining up our hitches. We're going to come in from the top, then pull our cord through the front of our working cord. Once you have a hitch ready, again, come in from the top, pull your working cord at the front, and this is all you need to do to get your half hitches. It is really easy, so do a few and you're going to get the hang of it. You can spread these hitches out as much as you want. The more you spread them out, the bigger the holes between the hitches will be, which will give it a net-like appearance. I have now reached the second row. The transitioning is again very easy. We simply take our working cord and go through the top and through the front of the cord, just like we did on the first row. And we are going to simply continue this until we reach the bottom. A quick tip, when you're making these hitches, you can, after you achieve certain length, tighten them up by simply pulling the slack from the first hitch to the last, pulling on each, and this will tighten up and even out your hitches, which is a great way to improve the look of your bottle wrap. Once you reach the bottom, it's time for our last step in making this bottle wrap, which is to again make another row on the edge of your wrap using the same technique that we used before. So we come in from the top and through the front of our working cord. After you've made one row, we're going to now switch to skipping one hitch. So basically we're going to skip one and go to the next and do this until we get to the very end. So we're going to do every second hitch using the same technique. This will quickly end our bottom, so it doesn't get too cluttered. Once we have reached the central point at the bottom, we're going to simply make another overhand knot, which we use to begin our wrap. And this completes our bottle wrap. So guys, thank you for joining me in this quick tutorial. I really do like this style of wrapping. I hope it will help you in your project. See you next time.